Fred and Sylvia Gleason have run the Jolly Farmer pub in Staines for the last 27 years. It's a popular watering hole for locals. Many have been coming here for years, and Fred and Sylvia aren't just seen as the people that pull the pints, but have also become part of a close community. But now those 27 years are up. Fred and Sylvia are leaving because they say they can't pay the new rent of £50,000 or the £150,000 it would cost them to bring the building up to scratch. And under new lease agreements, that's just what they would have to do.
I think it's absolutely diabolical. My wife and I love the trade. We've been in the business now, family-wise, over 50 years. My mother-in-law had a pub for 25 years. And we like the pub, we like the business. We would continue. We've got something to offer. And we will regret having to leave.
It's sad, really, because they're a very nice couple. They always make us welcome. And they're really friendly, and they do a lot.
In my opinion, it's totally unnecessary, because Fred and Sylvia have been marvellous publicans, and we've all enjoyed their company, they've enjoyed ours. And it all seems to me a matter of money now.
Other publicans across the country are also in the same situation as the Gleasons. New government rules have forced brewers to cut the number of pubs they own and instead offer new leases for pubs as free houses. Free in the sense they don't have to take their products. But it's causing major headaches.
I think it's a dismal story for many smaller publicans. I think what's happening is that the pub is turning from a social staple, if you like, into a luxury, and that luxury pubs, high quality pubs, pubs that are kept in a very good state of decoration and nicely furnished and so forth, they're doing well. But what we used to call the old spit and sawdust backstreet local, I'm afraid for them, they're going to the wall.
But the brewers, like Grand Metropolitan, which owns the Jolly Farmer, say the new leases give landlords security of tenure for the first time, and that rent rises are not excessive. Cold comfort for Fred and Sylvia, who say the cost of change has been their livelihood.
Thank you, Fred.